Hi, today I'm going to be showing you about FileMaker Go 15 app extensions. So let's go ahead and open up FileMaker Go 15 and let's go ahead and switch to this device tab here in the middle. So you notice, you might not notice, but up here in the top left hand corner there's a new folder icon with a down arrow. This is the app extensions logo or icon, and what this allows you to do is download databases and put them right on your iPad from cloud services. So it defaults to your iCloud, but you can also select Dropbox, OneDrive, any service you have installed, really. So I'm going to go ahead and choose Dropbox, App Extensions, and download this Assets database I created earlier. So great, that was pretty easy. Got that on there, you know, no problems, really smooth. And again, like I'll show you, now I'm in 14, and you'll notice that that button is gone. So how you used to have to do it is you'd have to manually go to Dropbox, you'd have to find your folder, find your file, wait for it to download, then you'd have to click this export button, you'd have to click open in, and then copy to FileMaker Go. So, I mean, it was definitely possible before, but just not very easy or user-friendly, so it's a great new way to do it is, you know, right through FileMaker, and it works really great. So go ahead and show you another place that app extensions comes in handy is with containers. So I'm going to click in this container, and you'll notice again that same icon at the bottom here, locations. So let's click on that, and I'm going to go ahead and just insert a photo from my OneDrive. All right, we'll just download Grumpy Cat, and then I'll show you what options you have available to you in 14. So let's create a new asset here. And you'll notice that locations is not here, but we do have files. So technically you could save it to your device and then do it that way, or save it to your photo library. But again, it just eliminates a bunch of unnecessary workarounds and makes it a lot more smooth to do that kind of stuff. Another cool thing that you can do is when you're exporting using app extensions. So I'm going to choose export. That name looks fine. And so, you know, we can assign it to a contact, we can print it, we can save it to our Dropbox. But one of the things I think is pretty cool is you can actually tweet it out without even leaving FileMaker. So I'm going to make a tweet real quick. We'll just say Grumpy Cat. And let's post that. So yeah, that's just definitely something you can't do, even come close to doing in FileMaker Go 14. Your only options when you were exporting from FileMaker 14, let's do this one, is to email or to save it. And so, I mean, that's not very useful compared to what you can do now. So let's go ahead and show another kind of file type that you can download, which is a Word document. So let me show you how that works. So I have this calendar Word document I've been working on, and FileMaker Go, it doesn't have a way to display Word documents natively, but now that you can install Microsoft Word on your iPad, and now that we have app extensions, you can now export it. Continue. We can actually open it directly in Microsoft Word. So it's actually a really cool feature that wasn't available to us at all before. So that's pretty cool. And another place where app extensions comes into place is when you're actually exporting data. So let's do an export of all this asset data that we have. So I'm going to create a spreadsheet. Let's keep the defaults. And you'll notice again we have the same kind of app extensions pane comes up, and we can save it to different locations, or again if you have Microsoft Word and Excel installed, you can open it right in that, which is, you know, really great, and allows you to, you know, format here and actually edit the data, add charts, do all that fun stuff. Whereas with 14, let's see how you could do this with 14. So if I wanted to export on 14, my two options are email and save. So let's just save it and view it. So when you view it, all you get is this, might as well be a PDF. It's just a, you know, you can't edit it, you can't do anything with it. And it just saves it to its default location in the Launch Center on the Device tab. You'll notice it's right there, the Assets Excel spreadsheet right there. So again, way more useful to be able to open that right up in Excel, work on it, and send it right from your iPad. The final thing that you can do with app extensions is actually save your database back up to the cloud. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm gonna click Save Database. We'll call this Assets Demo. Continue. I'm gonna save it to my Dropbox. And that looks good. Hit save. I might already have this in there, so it might ask us to replace it. Nope. Great. So yeah, now our database, we made changes and uploaded it to Dropbox. Whereas before, your only options in 14 were to email or save again. Those were kind of the only options you had. And emailing a database is not very practical when the size gets up there. So a lot of times before, you'd have to actually connect to iTunes and upload it that way, which was a pain. So glad that we have a new, easier way to accomplish this. So yeah, that is app extensions. We're all really excited about it here and think it offers a lot to the FileMaker world, and we're excited to see the exciting way people put them to use. So hope you like this video. Thanks.